Okay, here's some principles about making a video. First of all, there's the equipment and the costs. I'm using an Epson DocCam, costs about $500. The Camtasia software costs about $300. Microphone, about $20. Felt tip pens and markers, maybe about $10. Ballpoint pens don't really work. They don't get picked up at all. And pencils even worse. You need lots of paper and quite a few electrons. Okay, the basic design principles of making a video. The first one is keep it simple. You only want one topic per video. Attention spans are short. Just focus on one thing. You can always make another video about the next thing. Second principle is keep it short. 5 minutes is a good length. 10 minutes tops. The more advanced the topic you're teaching, the longer the attention span. So if you're doing something for an upper division course, maybe you could even push it as far as 15 minutes, but it's not recommended. A video is not record a lecture. You want to hit the point and move on. They can watch it a second time. Keep it lively. Don't write things out slowly. It can be very painful to watch. Keep it moving. You generally want to reveal, write, or at least point to something at all times. If there's a blank, if there's a screen where nothing is happening on the screen for a long time while you're explaining the most important thing in the world, why are you making a video? Okay, so to write or not to write. As I said, writing sentences is a bad idea, but writing figures is a good idea. For example, here we have a graph, and if you wanted to explain the graph, you know, on this graph you might want to describe the area under the curve between A and B, and you might want to break it up into little slices and talk about the area of each slice and the width of each slice. Or you might want to talk about a tangent line. You might want to draw a tangent line. You might want to draw a secant line and show how it's approaching a tangent line. There are lots of things that you can draw on a figure that add life to a presentation and that if you had prepared wouldn't look right. The fact that you're actively doing it is what makes it work. Calculations, you can either write or reveal. Often depends on how your handwriting is. My own handwriting is terrible, so I tend to use the reveal. Other people, like Elizabeth Stepp's handwriting, is wonderful. When she writes things out, it's just fine. Finally, there are the things that you do in post-production. Camtasia has a whole lot of features. Unfortunately, I never learned how to use most of them. Then you can upload it to YouTube. And then you can embed whatever you had into Quest or into a web page. And that's all it is. And with that, we'll stop.